following is a presentation of TFNN. The Money Masters. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Tom O'Brien and Tommy O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here. Right now, we have the Dow Industrials up 92. You get the NASDAQ down 6. S&Ps are up 10. Gold's up at $22. You get silver up 76 cents. Platinum's up $34. You get copper up 4 pennies. Bonds, the 10-year note is down 5 ticks. The 30-year bonds off 13 ticks. Good old King Dollar is down 480 ticks. And we get volatility and divergence.
There's some big, some big action already this morning.
Some big action. And, you know, the last couple days, folks, you know, Apple was kind of sticking its head out Friday and Monday. That it's like, okay, man, why you're moving down with some real juice. And, you know, we'll see where this good old Dow Industrials wants to take us. When we talk commodities, the bottom line is that these commodities are all moving. And when we talk commodities, we're going to go right over to our man, Mr. Kevin Hinks, because each and every trading day, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time, right here at TFNN, we have swim lessons. And if you happen to be in your car right now out in Portland, you know, driving down that beautiful highway, remember that right on your cell phone, you go to TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. You can listen to them every trading day, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. Kevin Hinks, what's going on?
Good morning, Tom. Good morning, Tommy. How you guys doing? It's earnings season.
It's earnings season on top of that. Yeah, that's what was.
That was a big one last night.
Netflix is getting
there
smoked.
There are some crazy markets. Hello?
Yeah, I got you.
Oh, yeah. There are some. Tom, I was just thinking, how is it that this market is driving to higher levels with IBM down, Netflix down, Apple down, Facebook down, and we're higher across the board?
Yeah, I know. Well,
crazy.
Yeah. I happen to like that inside the Dow because we know point-wise, you know, what can happen with the Dow when you're only talking 30 stocks, you know what I mean?
Right.
So like Goldman right now, folks, is putting 26 points into the Dow, United Health 18, and Johnson & Johnson 17, you know, so IBM's taken away 54.
Right. That's the amazing thing about all these financials right now. These guys are all beating these ground down expectations that they all have, and they're all trading so far below book value. We highlighted on Swim Lessons yesterday how Morgan Stanley's trading $26. They came out with their book value yesterday. $35.34 is their book value.
Right.
And the stock was trading $25 and change, rallied a little bit yesterday. It was up. It's trading about 26 and change today. Amazing what's going on in the financials.
That is amazing because that actually is, that's a problem, man. Because that's saying, the market is saying that, guess what, right? Your book value might be that, but we don't think it's going to be that next quarter or the quarter afterwards.
Right. You know what it is? It's really the long-term effect of these lower interest rates and what it does to any company that stores money.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, they're unable to overachieve because of the low interest rate.
Well, last night, right, you know, Tommy and I have been talking about just, you know, rates in general, and last night I'm looking at an ARM, right? And I got a nice mortgage right now, a nice 30-year mortgage, but I'm looking at an ARM and I'm saying to myself, okay, I can get a 3-year adjustable ARM at 2.25 right now, right? And I'm at 3.5, and I'm saying to myself, should I do that? And I was going back and forth saying, man, if rates get even cheaper, because what happens with an ARM, folks, it's off the ARM index. And the ARM index right now is only 0.25 of 1. You know what I mean?
Sure.
Yeah.
And so it's like, oh, man, I'm not going to do it. But I, you know, I'm almost at that point now saying, hey, these rates are going to stay low for a long period of time, you know?
Right. You're exactly right. And you know, now yesterday afternoon, Citigroup comes out and slashes the U.S. outlook. And part of what they're doing, they're discounting their GDP for the first quarter, GDP for the full year, because they see uncertainty in interest rates. And they don't think the Fed's going to, they think at the most it's going to be one time. So they lowered their U.S. outlook. So it's a crazy different market, and it's really giving people some fit on how to navigate through. That's for sure.
No doubt. Well, the cool thing is, as you just brought up, that we're at the beginning of earnings, so it'll get some basically, you know. My head, Kevin, I just went from a bull to a bear, okay? I just kind of flipped that whole position. I flipped it on Friday. I closed on Friday, but I just actually took the short positions this morning. And it's going to be intriguing because at the very beginning of this, of course, it is a mixed bag. It's a big mixed bag. Do you know what I mean?
Yes.
You know, like when I was pulling the trigger this morning, even on the NDX, you know, I was pulling the trigger more so because of Apple and the way it came down in Netflix, I says, okay, well, that's 12% of the NDX, okay? That's a good start. But there's no doubt that at the beginning of any turns, if in fact that is a turn, there's going to have to be other bigger stocks that fall apart. Do you know what I mean?
Right. So, and with Apple, you're about 6 days away from their earnings release.
Yeah.
You know, at Apple, and we've showed you on Swim Lessons, it's all about the iPhone.
Yeah.
Right? And you're getting some cross currents. Morgan thinks that iPhone sales are going to be higher than expected. And then you're getting some whispers from some of their suppliers, you know, are downgrading some of their numbers. And so I think some people are taking some risk off the table in Apple.
Yeah, no, I can see that. And that's a great phone, man. I don't have one, but I love them. It seems that people navigate Apple easier than anything. You know what I mean? Seems that way.
Absolutely right.
12 o'clock, folks, right here, TFNN, Swim Lessons. I'm in Mr. Kevin Hinks, Scott, Cindy, TFNN.com. Kevin, have a great one, a safe one.
Good talking to you guys, always. Have a good one.
You too. Tommy and I coming right back, folks. Stay right there. Dow up 91, Nasdaq down 3.5, S&P's are up 10.
Larry has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under trading newsletters.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
We take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. We get the Dow up 88, Nasdaq's down 3, S&P's are up 10.5. Let's go to Tom in Plymouth. Hey, Tom, what's going on?
Tommy, how are you?
Morning, Tom.
You look like you're doing pretty good, I think.
I'm doing excellent. I haven't talked to you since that oil popped up there, I don't know, a few weeks back. But prior to that, I had talked to you about the USLV, and you told me, no, don't jump into it yet. Let it pull back. So a few days before that UWTI popped, I did jump into it. And then when I sold that UWTI, I jumped into it some more.
Okay.
So I'm into it at like 12.36 in my average cost.
Wow.
And I'm wondering what you think where this thing could head.
So he has the USLV, folks, which is it's trading at 16.85, so he's up 33%. Right? Yeah.
And trust me, I'm very happy today with that.
Yeah. is that what we're looking at? Hold it.
Yes.
Oh, okay. That's right. Okay. So this is the 300% long position in silver. So what you have with silver out here today, silver's taking no prisoners. It's not moving higher last night. It's done 74,000 contracts. You're at 16.99. So... you know, 17.85 is game here. You know, that being said, man, you're up 33%. It's like, you know, I just said to Tommy, I'm going to do an update in the gold report just to move a few of these out after the program today. Do you know what I mean? So
maybe get rid of half the position and then.
You don't get those types of moves. You know, we have one, and you know, guess what? You can gap again. But bottom line is that you know, when you're up 33%. On, you know, not like a small amount of shares. That is a monster deal, man.
Okay, that's what I thought you might say, but I just wanted to run it by you, see what you thought, and great. I got to hand it to you. Love you, brother.
Love you, man.
All right, man, take care.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. That's quite a trade, huh?
He's been doing well with that USLV.
I know. It's pretty intense.
And that is a trade, for sure.
I'm telling you, man, off these small numbers. Big moves off these small numbers. That's silver market, man. When that takes off, man, that just takes no prisoners. And, you know, when I was listening to Larry, evidently it took off in the middle of the night last night. Yeah, that's what it looks like. 2:00 in the morning. It's like they came in, and there's some volume there, man. I mean, it's surprising that even that liquid. There's 3,900 contracts on a couple of those bars. So if we go over to the NDX 100 to see what's going on inside the NDX. So the leader inside the NDX 100, now this is pretty cool. This is Indo International. Now we know that's, I'll show it to you, but that's a dog. That's up $1.20. That's down from like big numbers.
Yeah.
Mylan Pharmaceutical is number 2. That's up $1.31. Western Digital is up 88 cents and Vodafone is up 69. Taken away from it. Look at this thing, man. This got taken apart. Alumina. It's down $41.
Just put it, that's 23%.
That's insane. So let me just see, did they come out with numbers or something? Alumina drops most, yes. First quarter sales fall short. You're talking about taking something to the cleaners, right? That's like sick. It's gonna go after, you get that high volume, low. That's interesting too. See, now this is where this gets wild, folks, is that you have, you know, we came down, hard, oh no, that's October 15. So this has a high volume low of October 15. That's $130. That's where it wants to go. We'll see how it handles that. Let's go back just to NDX for a second. Netflix is number 2. That's down 11.77. Liberty Braves? That's weird. That's down $1.53. And then Liberty Braves C. This must be an IPO. One second.
Sure.
What happens is that Liberty Braves rated new underweight at Morgan Stanley. The resumes, no reason. I'm not sure what this is. Liberty Braves Group Investor Meeting. This is this. I know what this is. Okay, so this is Liberty Media. They keep spinning companies off. This guy is so smart. This is one of the big cable guys. Liberty Braves Group operates a media company. The company offers media, communication, entertainment. Liberty Braves Group conducts business in the United States. Yeah. So that's he has a lot of different types of shares, and he just keeps pushing them off. That's John Malone. That's the guy that has started. He was the big media guy. So inside the Dow Industrials, we take a look at the Dow. Dow out here, the mover inside the Dow, you got Goldman Sachs up 4.43, Johnson & Johnson's up $2, you got Disney up 1.95, United Health's up 2.38. Taken away from it, Big Blue is down $8.16, Microsoft's off 32, Home Depot's down 77, and Apple is off 49. Let's go to Big Blue for a second. So that's done 900,000 shares. Yeah, it's coming down with volume. You know, Big Blue just can't handle it. Now, this, you know what's so crazy about this? Is that Big Blue finally made their numbers and made their revenue number. It's the first quarter, lots of quarters. Because Big Blue's just been buying back their stock for like 7 or 8 years.
Okay.
But the market still doesn't believe it. You know? If we go over to the NDX 100, so we were talking with Mike from Dallas yesterday, right?
Yes.
About, and let's bring this up. And I want to show you, Mike, okay, when you're talking spreads, so this morning, you know, and the NDX was, you know, up really nice. 6 o'clock in the morning, it was up there at 45.50.83. Even by 7:30, the first leg down, it was at 45.75. And when you take a look at the spreads that were out there, and of course I got my Bears clothing on a couple days ago, but I hadn't pulled the trigger yet. And so I'm sitting at my kitchen this morning, I'm saying to myself, okay, man. And doing the show yesterday afternoon, what was happening is that someone had called about Apple, and then I saw that Apple had gone down 2 days in a row, and I'm saying to myself, okay, man, that's a signal that a sector may start falling apart. And then, of course, Netflix come out, and I said, okay, the NQs would be the deal. Now, can you just bring that up? Because when you talk about risk, if you can bring the contract up, I just want to show them, when you're talking about the spread, I thought it was a really nice risk versus reward for where we were, do you know what I mean, at that time in the marketplace.
Yeah, so that would have been what you were doing right there.
Right.
So the spread goes 45.10 to 45.90.
Yeah.
Right? So 45.
80 point spread.
Yep. 45.50 is going to be in the middle, square.
Yeah.
That would be where you're risking 400 to make 400.
Right.
So it looks like you got in at about 7.35 this morning.
Yeah.
At 45.73. So when you're selling it at 45.73, you're going to be risking 170,
right,
which is basically the difference between 45.73 and 45.90.
Yeah.
For your max profit of 6.30, and that's if it hits a floor of 45.10.
Right.
And you're down to 45.45.
Right.
Which, you know, I agree.
And it's not a binary. You know what I mean?
No, it's not. And that's what we talked about kind of yesterday with Mike.
You're right.
Where you know, you're heavily towards the top end of that spread,
right,
yet you're within the middle of it. So you have some intrinsic value already in there.
Right.
And then...
And I was watching the markets trade in Europe.
Right,
there's a lot of action there. You stay right there, folks. Tommy and I come right back.
A new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio. Don't miss out on the Market Safe Commodity Solutions CD from EverBank. This is the second running of their popular 5-year U.S. dollar-denominated CD, which gives you exposure to 8 equally weighted commodities, including WTI crude oil, gold, silver, copper, nickel, soybeans, corn, and sugar. With annual pricing caps of 70% per component, you could earn up to 70% upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There's no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this indexed CD. Don't miss out. Take advantage of this financial resource designed to grow with the times. The May 19th funding deadline is quickly approaching. So hurry over to everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
John Logan has just announced that he is hosting a workshop Wednesday, April 20th for all TAS Profile Scanner Plus subscribers, opportunities in the current market, and strategies to profit. In this hour-long workshop, John Logan will use the TAS Profile Scanner Plus to give you a current breakdown of the sectors in the market and the opportunities that are present, as well as providing subscribers with the best strategies to trade with to profit when using this powerful piece of market scanning software. Right now, you can sign up for the TAS Profile Scanner Plus at the front page of TFNN.com. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is such an amazing piece of software that we're even offering a no-questions-asked money-back guarantee for all new paying subscribers. Don't delay, as John Logan's subscriber event is coming up soon. Sign up now for the TAS Profile Scanner Plus and be up and running within minutes using this powerful piece of market scanning software. With a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Sign up today.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
S&Ps are up 9.5, and you know what you also had there, which was pretty neat, which is unusual, is that the NQs were up really quite a bit when that happened. You see what I'm saying? The NQs, they were up 28 points.
I don't follow the unusual part of it.
Well, that was pre-market.
Okay.
They were already up 28 points.
Okay.
And I still had another 17 points to go before I'd be out of the money totally. Do you know what I'm saying? So I was looking at
the master spread. If it's up huge pre-market, then it's going to be near the ceiling of that spread somewhat. Do you see? I mean,
I do.
If you want to short a highly positive market,
right,
there's going to be opportunities at the top ends of those spreads.
Right, which I like.
Very often, though.
Right.
Not unusually.
Right. Okay.
Do you see?
I do.
Yeah.
I do. The
you have to go against where it's come, as in you're going against where it's already up heavily. So there are
my point is that the energy was there was so much energy that was already expended to be up 28 points. You see what I'm saying? In the futures market, that they had to get up another 28 points, another 17 points just to get to the top of the spread. But I understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
The TAS tomorrow night. I'm in. Mr. John Logan's going to be doing a workshop.
Yeah. Sure, we can pull that up. Yeah. So we're right on the heels of that Tiger Dollar sale.
Yeah.
So it's coming up on us quickly, but it's tomorrow night. And so TAS Profile Scanner Plus subscribers tomorrow night with John Logan, basically talking about the opportunities in the current market and, you know, strategies using the scanner on how to profit. So it'll be 5:30 to 6:30. And now's a great time to give it a try.
Yeah.
You have 30 days. You get a money-back guarantee. You know, you sign up, you pay for your first month. But if you're unsatisfied for any reason, you can get a money-back guarantee, attend tomorrow night's webinar. And I'm sure if people are watching us now, they might have seen John Logan on the show. They've seen the scanner.
Right.
And hopefully they've given it a try because it's awesome. You use it. I use it for sure.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
You know, and what happens, folks, is that if you can't make it live, it's going to be on your page for 30 days. So check it out. And, of course, every trading day, 8 o'clock in the morning, he kicks us off, 8 to 9. Walks through all these markets, which is just fabulous. And Andy, heck, I wonder if Andy made it to Denver. We got to find out because he was worrying about flying out there because of the snow.
Yeah.
And then down in Houston, man,
it's flooding, right?
Yeah. That's crazy.
It is.
That's, they had, yesterday we were talking about that insurance deal.
Yes.
Okay, so they had in the Tampa Bay Times today. The Tampa Bay Times actually got two Pulitzer surprises.
Pulitzer prizes.
Thank you. Yesterday.
And so did you say they got two yesterday?
They got two yesterday. Not for that, but okay. This is a pretty amazing. Remember I said that this paper's amazing, but
you think a lot of things are amazing.
Well, it is.
You always think your hometown paper's amazing, but that's okay. You can always think that.
So. inside the paper this morning, what they had, which is really unusual for Florida folks, because most of the time the regulators in Florida are behind the, the whole deal, not in front of it. What they were talking about was that there was two politicians that were trying to get that bill done on this insurance deal. There's a bill that's going through the Florida House right now that absolutely says that these insurance companies have to go after their beneficiaries, okay?
Have to pay out the policies.
Have to pay out, and have to, if they, what they said is this. So picture that, how crazy this is, folks. The insurance companies, and this has been going on since the 1960s. They have policies in the 1960s, 70s, and 80s that,
I saw the story,
that
right.
haven't been we paid, about, yeah. right? Well, it had in the paper this morning that if you have an annuity, okay, so the way an annuity works, right, is an annuity insurance company has to always pay it out, right? Well, guess what? They always knew when someone died in the annuity, and they stopped it right away, right? The neat thing I thought was that there were two politicians in Florida that, what the story was saying, that they were all over it, and the law in Florida is going to change. And they've been trying to fight this for the last 15 years.
Okay.
They've known about it.
Yeah.
And it's finally going to go through.
Yeah.
Pretty sick. It really is. It's like, oh my God. So, the NQs right now. The NQs, they just went from, let's take a look here. What you're going to be looking for today, folks, is this, is that how the NQs back down will give you a decent indication that is the turn in the marketplace, and the NQs and the NASDAQ are going to lead the way down. You need an expansion of volume on the way down. So thus far, the first sell at 9:30, we went from 45.67 to 45.45. It got hit big. Now you're trying to get into that level. We're at 45.50. So we'll see whether we can make it up into that level once again. If we take a look at the three Qs, right now you get 13 million shares, and that's a lot of shares, but you haven't got price destruction yet. You're only down 33 cents. That's nothing. If we go take a look at the shares in the NYSE, we're at 224, which is short volume. And on the NASDAQ, we're at 451. The NASDAQ's getting some juice. We take a look at the SPYs, the SPY. The SPY is up 21 million. So that's short volume. Inside the, see that dollar wants lower price, man. It's going to be wild to see. The notes and the bonds are down, which is unusual because the market's giving it up a little. So it's like, do these notes and bonds actually want to go higher? And the market will take conniptions on that. Everyone will take conniptions on that if we start getting higher rates, even though they're so low right now. So the dollar, this is coming, I think it would take another day to go after that low out there, but the dollar right now is down 455 ticks, and 93.94 is that swing low. That's 23,000 contracts right now. I've done 11,000. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Inside the dollar, someone's giving it up inside there. Some of the higher volume stocks in this low volume market right now. Netflix is one of the leaders. That's down $11. Chesapeake Energy's up 29. Actually, let's go look at some of these energy stocks because oil held, man. So you get ExxonMobil's up. That's up 28 cents. CVX. Look at that. It's taking over its high. It's going to be wild here. This is going to be a battle. So the November 3rd high, $98.64, taking it out. And that XLE, this is what it might take, this XLE to get up into that. Look at that. It's going to do it, man. So the XLE is up $1.14. And that benchmark up there just might take that to have the Dow fall apart, that $70.88. All right, 65.72 right now.
Yeah.
And you know it's weird, man. When you look back, what has happened many times is that you can see the NASDAQ tops out 2 or 3 months before the S&P, the Dow, you know. I mean, they don't have to top out at the same time, but it's going to be intriguing watching this shake out. You stay right there, folks. Tommy and I are coming right back. Dow right now is up 59, NASDAQ down 6, S&P's up 8. We're going to be right back.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 51. NASDAQ's down 6. S&P's are up 7. Let's go to Market for Collins. Hey, Mark, what's going on?
Not too much, guys. How are you doing?
Doing great, man. We're getting all gassed up.
Yeah, that gas is, it's moving almost more than silver today. So I was thinking, I was looking at one of the natural gas companies, Chesapeake, and that looks like it's about ready to confirm an ABC. Actually, it has already confirmed an ABC up to about 750-ish. So I think that's right. Maybe I didn't get my numbers right. 150 to 570-ish. So what's that?
Yeah. That's $4, right? At 425. Yeah, 775, right.
Yeah, so anyways, just wondering what you think about... I don't have the natural gas actual contract. I'm not able to pull that with the number, the actual contract. Can you see what that's doing?
Sure.
As far as numbers go, because so, UNG, it isn't always right.
So. Yeah, what you had out here today, folks, natural gas is the mover. Natural gas is up 4.6% this morning. You're trading at 214, this contract is. Silver's up 4.3%. The contract that we're looking at is the June contract.
And Mark, just to throw it out there, you can always download that Nadex account and have live quotes on the commodities that we use. I mean, we use it ourselves, just to keep that in mind.
Yeah, it's awesome, folks.
It is.
Okay, so, wow.
UNG's volume's okay, but it's not phenomenal.
Yeah, this isn't phenomenal either, man. I'd be careful with this. This is weird, man. You get 40,000 contracts. It has the price move, there's no doubt, but, you know, you're coming into, I wouldn't be biting on this. You're coming into 92,000 contracts at $2.12, and it's over.
I'm sitting on a couple of just 650 calls on UNG, and I've got a good profit on them. So I was thinking of taking them off if the volume wasn't so good.
Yeah.
And it's not on the UNG itself.
No, so. It's not. And you come in, and it'd be so weird, folks. Okay, because it looks to me like natural gas really does want to go, but when you see a contraction of this much volume, it's like, oh, it's it. You know, the reward versus the risk just isn't there, man.
But yeah.
Particularly, you know, when you get, like, what moved that much, you know? I'm just asking that in general. Do you know what I mean? It's like, okay, the buyers didn't move it, you know?
Yeah. Well, on the UNG, it's got a swing high on the 4th of March, 703 on 9.6 million shares. And then it tried to get up there on the 13th with 12.75, so I was looking pretty good. And then it came back on light volume, and now today it's, what,
3.2.
Actually, it could have 12-ish.
Yeah.
It might not be too bad.
Let it lay out. It's early. I'd let it lay out for a while because it's only a quarter of a, you know, yeah. Because you know what? What happens, folks, is that it got to $6.92. Well, $6.93 is the high. And if it can get over that high, then you can see a lot of volume come in, you know.
And it can go to 703.
Yeah. You know. It will. I mean, I think it's a bullish deal. This might not be just the pop, you know what I mean? So today's Tuesday, so it's Thursday gas, right? Tomorrow's Wednesday. Tomorrow's oil. Yeah.
It seems like it's been moving early in the week, and then it drops right when they announce the numbers or right before, right after, and then... And it starts all over again.
Well, that's how it seems to be set up right now, man. You know, when you look at that future contract needs a lot more juice in order to basically, you know, sustain higher price. Doesn't mean it won't get to higher price.
Yeah. Okay, well, thanks.
Okay, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one. Let's go to John in Philly. Hey, John, what's going on?
Hey, Tommy. Thanks for taking the call. Tommy, I wanted to ask you if you could give me fresh eyes on a bear market that I'm looking for signs of bottoming. It's live cattle. I'm looking specifically at the June live cattle futures. I think that would be LEM6 for you. I'm not sure.
Yeah, no, I got it. It's LCM, all right?
Okay, and specifically, just wondering, your fresh eyes, what do you see here? Any chance of this making a bottom? And if so, where, as far as you see it, please?
So, cattle, folks, if we bring this back to December 17th, traded at $1.15 a pound, gets up to $1.31, backs down. Yesterday had big volume. I wouldn't bite yet, you know? I mean, that you're at 118. Let me do something. Let me see. LC1. I haven't traded this in a long time, man. And what happens with cattle, folks, cattle, well, when I traded it, it used to be non-volatile. That's why I really liked it. The way cattle's been trading, cattle went from $1.18 up to $1.67. Watch if I pull this back. That's almost unheard of because I remember it was just a penny each way. Yeah, so normally a penny each way is big money, and it stayed... Yeah, between 118 and 122, 132 for almost 2 years.
just to let you know, you're looking at the weekly right there. That's 127. That's the April, which is spot, and that goes off the board literally within days. And the active contract now is June, which is way down at 118.50. So if you see that weekly chart, you're way down at that low already.
Right, which is sweet. So we bring it back. I'd still let it test that low, John. That's the way it seems to me. You know, and it's because of the amount of volume that came in yesterday. You know, that was substantial. That's 31,000 contracts. It was coming into 30,000. So it broke that swing with volume. You can say it's an ABC down, man. Hold it. That's an ABC down. So 131 is your A, 120 is your B, so it's 11 cents, which gets you 113. 113 is the A to B equals C to D on that, and it broke it with volume yesterday.
Gotcha. Hey, thanks for the fresh eyes, Tommy. I appreciate it.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Isn't it funny that cattle, you buy futures on cattle too?
Of course.
It's just funny how it works. Let's go to Lou in Nashville. Hey, Lou, what's going on?
Hey, how are you doing, Tom?
Doing great, man. Yourself?
Okay. Not bad. Hey, I just saw a movie the other day that reminded me of you. Mystic River.
Oh, Mystic River, the pizza movie, right?
Yeah.
There's not like a good pizza.
I don't know. I don't think you're thinking of the right movie.
Oh, I'm not?
No. That's a deep. It's a deep, dark. It's not a pizza movie.
Oh.
But it's a Boston movie. That's what.
Okay.
Yeah. Right, Lou?
Yeah. Right. Sean Penn's in it.
Yeah. I think his kid gets taken or something like that.
Oh.
Yeah.
Not quite. I better see it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like it. I was thinking of getting into SQQQ.
You can do that. We bought these this morning. I mean, you know, between the Qs, the QID and SQQ, you know, my take is that, yeah, this is where, you know, it's like, okay, you can keep a tight stop on it.
Yeah. Just go over this, the ultra short.
Yeah, this is, thank you, yeah. The SQQQ, folks, is the 300%.
Q. Okay, go ahead. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, it's a 300%, right?
Yeah.
So it's the Prochia Ultra Shot 300% value.
Right.
You know.
Where do I put my stop if I bought it here?
Well, just stay right there. Well, I wouldn't give it much, man. Particularly because you're already day trading. Just stay right there. We'll be coming right back. This is Tom O'Brien. We want to hear from you folks. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow is up 51. NASDAQ is down 8. S&Ps are up 7. We're going to be right back.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD. Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-Share Bull and Bear ETFs. China A-Shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN. Educating investors.
Catch Basil Chapman as he uses his Chapman Wave methodology to call the markets. The Tiger Technician's Hour, next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. We're talking with Lou from Nashville. We're talking about the SQQQ, which is the 300% inverse correlation, which is the bear position. So what I would do, Lou, I wouldn't give it anything, because what should happen out here today is that, you know, we shouldn't, if we're right in the context, we shouldn't get a large counter trend bounce. So you're at 1749. I mean, you can put this stop into 1735. I'm not even going to the bottom. You know, where I'm going with that is that was at like 10 o'clock yesterday morning. Because it shouldn't cut. It shouldn't fail all the way down. That's what I'm talking, you know what I'm saying?
And I think we lost him right at the beginning of that.
Okay.
But hopefully he can come back and check the archive and get it there.
Right, right.
Give it to him.
Yeah, we might have just lost him on the phone too, which is cool.
Right, exactly.
Let's go to Jim in Oldsmar. Hey, Jim, what's going on?
Hey, how are you guys today?
We're doing great, man. Yourself?
Doing pretty good.
Cool.
I manage my own retirement account, and I was thinking about looking at the ProShares Ultra Short S&P 500, the SPXU, but that thing ain't never done nothing but go down, so I didn't know.
So this is the 300% inverse correlation of the S&P. It's just the, you know, yeah, and, you know, since we've come up from May 20th, this has gone from a price point of $43 down to $27.
Market goes straight up, this is going to go straight down.
Right, no doubt. Now, you were thinking of buying this just to hedge your portfolio? Is that what you're thinking?
Yeah.
Because you're long. What happens?
I was just thinking that the markets are overbought, and I was just thinking that they'd probably be coming down and that this would go up.
Well, what happens is this, is that that's a good idea. I mean, except that I wouldn't use a leverage product to do that, because the doubles or the triples, they're daily investment vehicles, and if this market goes sideways, you know, for another 2 months, they'll both, bull and bear positions will lose money. You know, so they reset themselves every day. You know, you could just turn around and go short the S&P, the SPY, and then that would give you a one-to-one on your correlation instead of trying to get something that does not correspond to the longer-term direction of the marketplace.
Yeah, but this is an IRA account, and in an IRA account, I can't short.
What a killer. Okay, that's right. But hold on, we're going to get you one, because anyone in the den, who knows the one that's a shot that you can buy? There's one. There's a shot, a one-to-one.
I think it's, they're saying, called short, S-H-O-R-T. S-H-G, maybe.
S-H-G, that was S-H-G. S-H. Cool, man. Okay, here, we're going to get something for you, I think. S-H, here you go, man. Okay, so you can buy this one, the IRA. This is an exchange-traded fund, fund seeks investment inverse. So it's the S-H. You can buy. That's right. You can do that. This is cool, man. Thanks, guys. It's a single one-to-one shot the S&P, but you can buy it because it, you know, if the S&P goes down, this goes up. So you're not shorting, well, you are shorting the market, but they feel like you're going long the market so you can get it in the IRA.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's good. That's, I appreciate it.
Absolutely, man. Thank you so much. Have a great one.
Okay.
Have a safe one. Thanks, you tigers and tigresses, and you can hold it, which is great. Because if you get a sideways market, it's crucial to understand, folks, the bull and bear positions of doubles and triples in a sideways market can hurt you.
And you know, we were just in the den. You get a den subscription if you sign up for the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. So
oh, how cool is
there
that?
There you go. Sign up for that, and you'll be rocking and rolling.
And the den is awesome, folks. You want trading ideas, man. You want a trading community, you know, basically 12 hours a day. Check it out. You stay right there, man. Mr. Basil Chavez coming up next. Swim Lesson, Steve Rhodes, Dave White, myself, and Andy's teaching.
Hopefully he's in
Denver.
Thanks,
pal.
Thanks, man.
Bam! Go get him, folks.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.